This video is sponsored by Eraser. Check the description and keep watching to learn more. Today's world of always-on applications have increased their requirements on availability and reliability. Users want all systems to be up and running 24/7 with little to no failures. We also have been creating apps and services that need to be available for billions of users worldwide, and these people want apps to be fast. So scalability and performance have also become a very important aspect of today's systems. All of this has increased the prevalence of one type of system, distributed systems. But what is a distributed system? Explained in a simple way, a distributed system is a group of nodes located on different network computers which communicate and coordinate their actions by passing messages to one another in order to achieve a common goal. There are some inherently distributed systems like the internet, for example, but there are additional reasons to build distributed systems. They are important because they allow us to build large-scale applications that can handle huge amount of data and traffic and allow us to design applications that are fault-tolerant and scalable. Finally, when architected correctly, distributed systems also allow development teams to scale better. Let's take a look at some of the characteristics and challenges of building distributed systems with an example. Let's imagine a library app that allows you to rent books. We have a frontend, an API gateway, some services including an inventory, and a database to store the number of available books to be rented. Whenever the user accesses the app and searches for a book, we want to show them how many books are actually available for rent. And here we start seeing some of the challenges. For example, there can be a problem connecting to the database. How does a service know which database to call and how to reach it? Network can be down or it could be congested. We need to be sure the communication is secure to prevent eavesdropping. The client may also retry a request twice if it didn't get a confirmation for the first request. The network is unreliable. The network package can be lost, routers or switches can fail, there can be congestion, or nodes geolocated on different regions, making latency increase. There are also bandwidth limitations and security concerns that must be taken into consideration. This can be solved by implementing some network protocols, service discovery, or even some properties like idempotency. We can group all of these challenges under communication challenges. Getting back to the example, the user might wait forever for the page to load or receive an error that the service couldn't connect to the database. To prevent users from noticing these failures, we could add timeouts and automatic retries, or add replication. For example, if we have multiple instances of the same database, we might be able to switch to another instance if one is failing or connectivity to it is failing. It can also help with load balancing in case there is too much traffic. We could also add a cache, so the user would get an outdated result instead of an error. We could also split the data between different database instances, so if one fails, only the results from that instance fail, but not for all the queries. This is called sharding. We could group all of the challenges under scalability and resiliency challenges. But even implementing some of these solutions can be quite complex in a distributed system. Take the example of replication or sharding. If we have multiple database instances, how do we make sure the data stays consistent? One way to do this is to have a leader or main instance that is used for writes, and the rest of the instances copy the data from the leader database to serve only read calls. This means that we need a way to decide which instance is the leader, and what happens when the leader fails. How can we do transactions, and what happens when an instance copies a write that was then reverted? Since different nodes need to collaborate towards a common objective, coordination is required. There are several challenges that come into play here, like how to keep time, how to process transactions, and even how to detect failures. We can group all of these under the coordination challenges. Most of the cost of software comes during the maintenance activities. We need to take into consideration certain concepts and practices that allow us to lower these costs in the long term. These include things like testing, monitoring, and alerting. But it also includes things like having a clear design and good documentation. In this area, even though I really enjoy doing architecture diagrams by hand, when I'm working on a system that I need to evolve, document, or contribute with teammates, I like to use a tool like Eraser. Eraser is a diagrams and docs hub for engineering teams. It can be used to draw architecture diagrams, create technical planning docs, conduct whiteboard interviews, and sketch wireframes. Eraser differentiates with depth-targeted features like markdown notes, diagram as code, and keyboard-first flowcharting. I personally like how easy Eraser is to use. Some of the top features I like the most are the keyboard shortcuts and the diagrams as code. Look how easy it is to create the diagram we just did earlier in today's video. I don't even need to use the mouse. I can just use the insert menu, select diagram as code, and start creating my diagram. And I can easily update it directly in the code and export it to GitHub. You too can start using Eraser for free today. Check the link in the description below. As we saw today, by taking into account the design considerations and choosing appropriate architecture, we can build systems that meet the demand of modern applications. Distributed systems are a very special type of systems that are very powerful, but come with very complex challenges. We can group these challenges into communication, scalability, reliability, coordination, and maintainability. I will be covering them more in depth in my next videos, so if you don't want to miss them, just click and subscribe. And don't forget to check the resources in the description below. Thanks for watching.